Brakashandara baba leporia. Yebre kese kele bori baba kashanda rebolia. Bore boskende rebobole pakasanda baba leporia.
All I have is you.
Rabba shekele.
Jesus. All I have is you.
Father, we give you all the glory. Father, we give you all the honor. Father, we give you all the adoration. You are worthy to be praised. You are worthy to be worshipped. You are worthy to be adored. We thank you for all that you have done for us in the past 1 week. Hallelujah to your holy name, Lord. Oh, Father, I don't have anything but you, Lord. You are the only thing that I have, oh Lord. Mariba Shakaya Baba Leporia. Have is you. Hey, Jesus, all I have is you. Oh, Jesus, all I have is you. Rabba Shakaya Baba Lepori Baba. Father, for all that you have done for us in the past 1 week, we give you all the glory, we give you all the honor, we give you all the adoration. Father, you are worthy to be praised, you are worthy to be worshipped. Father, we bow before you even as we gather together again this afternoon in this prayer meeting. Blessed be your holy name, O God. We thank you, Father, because we serve a God that answers by fire. Hallelujah to the holy name of God. Father, take all the worship. Father, take all the praise. Father, take all the adoration, O Lord, in the name of Jesus.
Increase you on every side. Hallelujah, Marebo Shandaraba. If not for the blood of Jesus. 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 The blood of Jesus that has made us whole. Jesus, I cannot thank you enough. I cannot thank you enough. That blood that you shed on the cross of Calvary delivered me from every wickedness of darkness. That blood that you shed on the cross of Calvary separated me from the idols of my father's house. Oh, Lord Jesus, I thank you. I thank you. I thank you, Jesus. I thank you, Jesus. You are welcome to this prayer meeting. Mary Ovieria Ipunwekai. You are welcome in the name of Jesus. Oyowe Timoye Gloria. You are welcome in the name of Jesus. As you step into this meeting, step into the power of the Most High God. Step into the power of the Most High God. Step into the power of the Most High God. Balaba Shakaya Baba Lebori Baba. Moses, oh, you are welcome, Daddy. God bless you in the name of Jesus. Patricia Kalu, you are welcome in the name of Jesus. You are welcome into the presence of the Most High God. You are welcome. Good afternoon. God bless you in the mighty name of Jesus. It shall be well with you. Anas Jack, you are welcome in the name of Jesus. You are welcome into the very presence of Jehovah. Where your life is going to be turned around. Where the glory of God is going to overshadow your life. In the mighty name of Jesus. Your life will not remain the same after this prayer meeting. In the name of Jesus. We just want to thank him. For all that he has done for us. In the past 1 week. Mary, the same way, you are welcome in the name of Jesus. Oh, this God is a powerful God. This God is a wonderful God. He's the God of signs and wonders. He's the God that answered by fire. Palmare Bashikaya Boli Baba. Oluwani Femi Salam. You are welcome in the name of Jesus. La Bashikaya Boli Baba Kaskanda Baba. As we are entering into this prayer meeting, let the fire of his presence begin to purify your life. Begin to sanctify your life. Let the fire of his presence. Oh yes, adios, you are there, okay? God bless you, man. You are welcome in the name of Jesus. Let the fire of his presence begin to purify your life. Begin to sanctify your life. In the name of Jesus, your life will not remain the same again. After this meeting, after this week, the Lord will launch you to your greatness. 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 The Lord will launch you into your greatness in the name of Jesus. Oh, you have become unstoppable by the power and the blood of Jesus. You have become unstoppable. Adam Sebari, you are welcome in the name of Jesus. Maria Bashakayaba, Rebra Kasandara Babalimuria. Keep on sharing. Keep on doing a watch party.
I will never
with this prayer meeting. It's going to be fire today. It's going to be deliverance today. It's going to be salvation today. It is going to be healing today. Infinite Jesus. Good afternoon from here. God bless you in the name of Jesus. Keep on liking. Keep on liking the page. Keep on liking the page. Keep on loving the page. The Lord will love you too. The Lord will like you too. The Lord will love you too. The Lord will like you too. He will enlarge your course. He will enlarge your course. He will enlarge your course. Make sure you are inviting at least 14 people today. Make sure you invite 14 people today. The Lord will lift up your hands. The Lord will lift up your hands. In the name of Jesus. The Lord that lifted the hands of Moses in the wilderness shall lift up your hand this afternoon. The Lord that lifted up the hands of David and of Moses in the wilderness shall lift up your hands. 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 Sammy Babali, God bless you, man. You are welcome in the name of Jesus. Nancy Johnson, you are welcome in the name of Jesus. I say, as the Lord lifted up the hands of Moses in the wilderness, the Bible says, whenever the hands of Moses are lifted up, Israel was winning the battle. Whenever his hands are down, he said the Amalekites were winning the battle. Ah, today, the Amalekites, the Midianites, oh yes, they will no longer win the battles of your life. The satanic herdsmen, the satanic spiritual herdsmen, they will no longer win the battle of your life. In the name of Jesus, they will no longer destroy the garden of your life, the farmland of your life. In the name of Jesus, Rabba Shakala Balebori Baba, Marebo Skanda Lebori Baba Kasekeleboria, Bareba Sande Lebori Baba Kasekelebori Baba, Barebo Skanda Baba Leboria. Father, we thank you. Keep on sharing. Keep on sharing. Invite 14 people. Invite 14 people into this grand finale of prayers. And the Lord that you seek will suddenly appear in his temple. In the name of Jesus, the Lord Josephine Elo, you are welcome in the name of Jesus. The God that we seek on this mountain shall suddenly appear. In the name of Jesus, the God that we seek on this mountain shall suddenly appear. In the name of Jesus, the God that we seek on this mountain shall suddenly appear by his mighty power. The Lord will appear in his glory. The Lord will appear in his power. The Lord will appear in his glory. The Lord will appear in his power. The Lord will appear in his glory. The Lord will appear in his power. The Lord will appear in his glory. The Lord will appear in his power. Hey, Marika Suri Babaka Shandarebulia. For in Jesus' name we pray. You are welcome in the name of Jesus. I bless God for your life. Your life will not remain the same. The Lord will promote you by fire. The Lord will lift up your head. The God that you have been crying to on this platform, the God that you have been crying to on this mountain, will lift up your head. Yes, Charmin, Sonye, you are welcome in the name of Jesus. Your head must be lifted up. The enemy does not have any option. Your head must be lifted up. But Shakaya Baba, they cannot stop your head from being lifted up. Yes, they try to draw back the hand of your clock. But the clock is working normally again by the power and the blood of Jesus. Yes. Somebody is here. The enemy tried to draw back the hand of your clock. The enemy tried to delay the agenda of God for your life. I bless God for you this morning or this afternoon. Makashaka Yababa, the speed that heaven allocated to the agenda of God for your life has been reactivated. The speed that heaven allocated to the agenda of your God for your life has been reactivated. It has been reactivated. You don't understand. Before now, the enemy puts the agenda of your life at snail speed. At snail speed. Everything was just going slowly, terribly slowly for you. But by the power in the blood of Jesus, by the power of resurrection, yes, the speed that heaven allocated to the agenda of God for your life has been reactivated. Has been reactivated. And King Elijah, God bless you. You are welcome, sir. God bless you, man. You are welcome in the name of Jesus. Oh, yes. Your destiny will begin to go at a fast pace now. By the power and the blood of Jesus, your destiny will begin to go at a fast pace now. By the power and the blood of Jesus, your destiny can no longer be slowed down. Your destiny can no longer... Tiunda, Clara, you are welcome in the name of Jesus. Mashakaya Buri Baba Kaskendeye, Rabasakata Ekaleuria, Holy Masuri Baba, every power that has been slowing down the speed of your destiny, Prince Ehige, you are welcome in the name of Jesus. Every power that has been slowing down the speed of your destiny, the speed of the agenda. Praise Miles, you are welcome in the name of Jesus. Every power that has been slowing down the speed of your destiny, the speed of your greatness, they shall be wasted by the power in the blood of Jesus. They shall be wasted by the power in the blood of Jesus. They shall be wasted by the power in the blood. Yes, they can slow down the speed of a man's greatness. The wicked can slow down the speed of a woman's greatness. What does that mean? It doesn't mean they are not going to be great, but it's going to take them longer time to get. Monica Amaichi, you are welcome in the name of Jesus. Malibu Shika Yabakaria. That's why you need to pray sometimes. Even though the enemy cannot stop you, but they can slow you down. Manama Sika Yabukuria. Ebreke Surima Makashandaraba. Labraka Sekande Rumina Shandaraba. Borima Surima Makashanda. You are going to shout it loud and clear. Say powers! Slowing down the speed of my greatness, fall down and die by the power in the blood of Jesus. Every power that is slowing down the speed of my greatness, the speed of my wife's greatness, the speed of my children's greatness, fall down and die. Ah, that be your daily away, yeah, prophet. God bless you, sir. You are welcome in the name of Jesus. Russell Grant, you are welcome in the name of Jesus. Powers! Adeyemi Tayo Hali. Powers! Slowing down the speed of my greatness. For that, 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 for that. In the name of, yes, sometimes heaven can appoint two people at the same time to get to the same destination at the same time. While one is getting to that destination at heaven's speed, at heaven's time, the other one has been slowed down by wicked powers, and they are not getting there when they are supposed to get there. Somebody say, I prophesy to your life, from today, you will get to your destination at heaven's speed, at heaven's time. In the name of Jesus, it will no longer be the time of your enemy. In the name of Jesus, your marriage will no longer be the time of your enemy. It shall be heaven's time. It shall be heaven's, at heaven's speed, by the power in the blood of Jesus. Everything that they have slowed down in your life, I say, gather speed now by the power and the blood of Jesus. Every good thing that the enemy has slowed down in your life, let them begin to gather speed again by the power in the blood of Jesus. Every good thing that the enemy has slowed down the speed in your life, let those good things begin to gather speed again. Begin to gather speed again by the power in the blood of Jesus. Let them begin to gather speed again. Let them begin to gather speed again by the power in the blood of Jesus. Let them begin. Omolaja Adeleji, you are welcome in the Omolaja Adeleji. And so, hey, good judge, you are welcome in the name of Jesus. Yes, every good thing that the enemy has slowed down in your life by the power of prophecy, by the power of prophecy, let them begin to gather speed again. Let your marriage gather speed. Let your career gather speed. In the, let your business gather speed. Let your career, your job, your finance, your business, your investment begin to gather speed again by the power in the blood of Jesus. Let your business begin to gather speed. Begin to gather speed. Rehima Sandy, you are welcome in the name of Jesus. Huh. I bless God for God. Our God is an awesome God. When you look at the atrocities that the wicked commit in the lives of men and women, it is terrible. It is terrible. A man has been placed on the high lane. Amen. The lane of high speed of life. And the wicked will relocate them to the slow lane. Mariga Ege Idehen, you are welcome in the name of Jesus. Good afternoon to you. Good afternoon to everyone in the name of Jesus. Oh, yes. Somebody's here. You need to pray. Say powers that want Stella Kimani. You are welcome in the name of Jesus. Now take that prayer very well. Stella, take that prayer very well. Say powers that want to relocate me to the slow lane of life. Powers that want to relocate me. You didn't feel it. You are welcome in the name of Jesus. Powers that want to relocate me to the slow lane of life. You are a liar. Fall down, die. 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 Fall if you understand that prayer, you will pray better than the way you are praying now. You don't understand what it means. You are traveling on the fast lane. Everything is coming for you in time. Everything is working. God bless you, sir. You are welcome in the name of Jesus. You are traveling at heaven's speed and heaven's time. But all of a sudden, the wicked just, diverted it, relocated you from high speed to low speed, to slowly. You are going to pray. Somebody said you need to pray because things need to happen in your life very fast. Things need to happen. The speed it is taking now is not the speed of heaven for your life. It is not the speed of heaven. I can see it. And that is why God has brought you into this prayer meeting. Say, powers that want to relocate my destiny to the slow lane of life. Powers that want to relocate my destiny to the slow lane of life. That wants to relocate my wife's destiny to the slow lane of life. That wants to relocate my children's destinies to the slow lane of life. Hear the judgment of the living God. Fall down and die in the name of Jesus. Fall down and die in the name of Jesus. Fall down and die in the name of Jesus. Fall down and die in the name of Jesus. Fall down and die in the name of Jesus. Fall down and die. Yes, if you are in this prayer meeting and you have that feeling that what you are supposed to do, Ladi, Ashezi, Afi, you are welcome in the name of Jesus. If you realize that in your life, what you are supposed to do in 1 week is taking you 1 month. What you are supposed to do in 1 month is taking you 1 year. What you are supposed to do in 1 year is taking you 10 years. That is your prayer. Powers that want to relocate my destiny to the slow lane of life. Hear the judgment of God. That by fire, that by thunder, that by fire, that by thunder, that by fire. Be angry in your spirit. Be angry in your spirit. Be angry in your spirit. Manlabaka, those that are attacking you, they are not merciful. They are not merciful. They are not kind. They want you to get there late. How can somebody become a millionaire at the age of 70, at the age of 80? What happened to the age of 40? What happened to the age of 50? What happened to the age of 60? He's becoming a millionaire at the age of 70, at the age of 80, quarter to the grave. You can see the wickedness of men. Amen. Say, powers, delaying good things in my life, enough is enough. In the name of Jesus. Powers, delaying good things in my life, enough is enough. That backfire, that back thunder, 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 that backfire, that back thunder. In the name of Jesus, you need to get angry in your spirit. Beloved, we are in our 1 week deliverance from financial embarrassment and confusion. When things are coming late for you, why won't you be embarrassed? Amen. Every pattern of delay in my life scattered by the power in the blood of Jesus. A sister is looking at me right now. You need to open your mouth and cry out like a roaring lion. You need to open your mouth and cry out like a roaring lion. Say, every pattern of delay in my life scattered by the power in the blood of Jesus. Every pattern of delay in my life, in my wife's life, in my children's life, scattered by the power in the blood of Jesus. Scattered by the power in the blood of Jesus. Scattered by the power in the blood of Jesus. Scattered by the power in the blood of Jesus. Scattered by the power. Yes, Vivian, Vincent, you are welcome in the name of Jesus. Every pattern of delay in my life scattered by the power in the blood of Jesus. Scatter. Mami Bewo, you are welcome in the name of Jesus. Alice Godwin, you are welcome. Keep on sharing. Keep on sharing. Yes, you will no longer be delayed in the agenda of God for your life. You will no longer suffer delay in the agenda of God for your life. You will no longer suffer delay in the agenda of God for your life. Every pattern of delay in my life, in my wife's life, in my children's lives. Scattered by the power in the blood of Jesus. Scattered by the power in the blood of Jesus. Scattered by the power in the blood of Jesus. Scattered by the power in the blood of Jesus. Scattered by the power in the blood of Jesus. Scattered by the power in the blood of Jesus. Scattered by the power in the blood of Jesus. Oh yes. Delay in marriage. Delay in childbearing. Delay in career. Delay in getting a good job. You are working. But that's not what you train for. You went to school, you trained yourself properly, you spent money. But you are still doing many a job. Because household wickedness just want to embarrass you financially. They shall be wasted by thunder. They shall be wasted by thunder. They shall be wasted by thunder. In the name of God, that certificate that you acquired, but they didn't allow you to get a good job with it. Go out and get a good job from today by the power in the blood of Jesus. Go out and get a good job from today by the power in the blood of Jesus. Go out and get a good job from today by the power in the blood of Jesus. Go out and get a good job from today by the power in the blood of Jesus. Mashakaya babala. Go out and get a good job from today by the power in the blood. Somebody's here. Your son has graduated for the past 6 years. That's what I can see now. Your son graduated for the past 6 years. Amen. The same menial job he has been doing before he entered college is the same menial job, I will tell you. He's working in McDonald's. And he has a certificate, but he cannot get a job. Makasakata, I break that barrier today by the power in the blood of Jesus. I break that embargo today by the power in the blood of Jesus. I break that barrier today by the power in the blood of Jesus. Yes, your son has a degree, was working. There's nothing wrong with working in McDonald's, but the degree it's not for McDonald's. Makasakada, let there be a shift in the spirit realm by the power in the blood of Jesus. Let there be a shift in the spirit realm by the power in the blood of Jesus. Let there be a shift in the spirit realm right now in the name of Jesus. Ragiatu Kamara, you are welcome in the name of Jesus. Father, we bless your holy name. Keep on sharing. Keep on sharing. Invite 14 people to this prayer meeting. Because I know that Jehovah is going to perform wonders in our lives this afternoon, even by the power of his holy name. In the mighty name of Jesus. Oh yes, the man that heaven was talking about yesterday, the businessman, I'm hearing it again, that your divine helpers are already looking for you. They are searching for you already. Makasika Lemuria. Mori Baba, I don't know something about this man. This man has been joining us now for the past 3 days. The Lord said, Makaliba, Vivian Vincent Olode, you are welcome in the name of Jesus. Oh, yes. All those international connections that are meant to help you, they have been released. They are looking for you already. They are looking for you already. And within the next 3 weeks, like I said, in fact, 2.5 weeks, they will locate you by fire. They will locate you by fire. They will locate you by fire. Your story will change forever. Makasakatara baba leporia. Mariba suri baba kashkendeye. Manasakatari baba kaskeleboria. Boriba skandara baba lepori baba kaskendeye buria. Somebody said, they relocated your destiny to the burial ground. They relocated your destiny to the burial ground. Like the madman of Gadara in Mark chapter 5. Chika, Una, God bless you, sir. You are welcome in the name of Jesus. They relocated household wickedness, relocated your destiny to the burial ground. But by the power in the blood of Jesus, I deliver your destiny from the burial ground. By the power in the blood of Jesus, I deliver your destiny from the cemetery. By the power in the blood of Jesus, there is a sister here. I deliver your destiny from the cemetery. By the power in the blood of Jesus, I deliver your destiny from the cemetery. By the power in the blood of Jesus, I deliver your destiny from the cemetery. I deliver your greatness from the cemetery. I deliver your prosperity, your increase, your enlargement. Yes, from the cemetery, from the graveyard, by the power in the blood of Jesus. They took a piece of air from you. And they went to the burial ground to bury it.
Somebody's here. That's what I'm hearing in my spirit. The wicked took a piece of hair from you. They went to the burial ground to bury that piece of hair. By so doing, they buried every good thing in your life. Masakatari Baba. Somebody said, you are going to roar like thunder. Say, every good thing in my life, buried in the cemetery, be delivered by fire in the name of Jesus. Every good thing in my life, buried in the cemetery, be delivered by fire in the name of Jesus. Every good thing in my life, in my wife's life, in my children's lives, buried in the cemetery, buried in the graveyard. I recover you now by the power in the blood of Jesus. I recover you now by the power in the blood of Jesus. Every good thing buried in my life, buried in my wife's life, buried in my children's lives, in the cemetery, in the graveyard. I recover you now by the power in the blood of Jesus. I recover my marriage. I recover my home. I recover my wife. I recover my children. I recover my finances. I recover my greatness. I recover my prosperity. I recover my wife and my children's greatness and prosperity. Buried in the cemetery. Buried in the graveyard. By the power in the blood of Jesus. I recover. 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 Open your mouth and pray. It's not a joke. Joy, Louis, Smart, Odimba, you are welcome in the name of Jesus. You are just joining this prayer meeting. Because of you, I will pray that prayer again. You just joined this prayer meeting. It is heaven that directed you to join now for this prayer. Every good thing in my life, buried in the burial ground, I recover you now. By the power in the blood of Jesus, every good thing in my life, in my wife's life, in my children's lives, buried in the burial ground, I recover you now. By the power in the blood of Jesus, I recover you now. By the power in the blood of Jesus, my marriage, my career, my job, my business, my finance, buried in the burial ground, buried in the graveyard, I recover you now. By the power in the blood of Jesus, I recover you now. By the power in the blood of Jesus, my greatness, my prosperity, my wife and my children's greatness and prosperity, buried in the burial ground, buried in the cemetery, I recover you now by the power in the blood of Jesus. You pray that prayer very well. Jane Way, you are welcome in the name of Jesus. One of the operations of witchcraft. One of the operations, Monica Amaichi, you are welcome in the name of Jesus. One of the operations of witchcraft is to bury things. They collect things from you and they bury them. Somebody say, I pray this prayer. Any witch in my father's house burying good things in my life, fall down and die. In the name of Jesus, any witch in my father's house burying good things in my life, burying good things in my brother's lives, burying good things in my sister's lives, fall down and die. By the power in the blood of Jesus, any witch in my father's house, any witch in my mother's house, any witch in my in-law's house, any witch in my place of birth, any witch in this land of America, burying good things in my life, burying good things in my wife's life, burying good things in my children's lives. The Bible says, so far the witch is not to live. Therefore, fall down and die. 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 In the name of Jesus, open your mouth and pray like a warrior. Every witch bearing good things in my life be wasted by thunder. In the name of Jesus, every witch, every witch, every wizard, Louis Chibu, you are welcome in the name of Jesus. I pray for you. Every witch, every wizard that is bearing good things in your life shall fall down and die by the power in the blood of Jesus. They shall fall down and die by the power in the blood of Jesus. They shall fall down and die by the power in the blood of Jesus. They shall fall down and die by the power in the blood of Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory Bernard, you are welcome in the name of Jesus. Keep on sharing. Keep on sharing. Hallelujah. Amen. I seize this opportunity to pray for President Donald Trump. They told us he is tested positive to the COVID-19. Let the blood of Jesus overshadow him We don't want him to die. We don't want him to be sick. Let the blood of Jesus overshadow him and heal him and heal his wife, Melania, in the name of Jesus. Let the blood of Jesus enter into his blood right now and flush out the coronavirus in the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Oh yes, he caught it. Now he knows what it is. I know. Let the blood of Jesus overshadow President Trump right now. Let the fire of God begin to burn in his blood, in his water, in his flesh, in his bones. Yes, every deposit of affliction in his body, let the fire of God begin to destroy them in the name of God. Doris Obibo, you are welcome. Please join me to pray. He's our president in America. Yes, let the hand of God come upon him. Even right now, let him begin to see Jesus. Let him see Jesus face to face. Let Jesus lay his hands upon him and heal him in the name of Jesus. The Bible says we should pray for our leaders. We should pray for men and women in the position of authority. They said he has COVID-19. Right now, let the blood of Jesus inoculate him. Let the blood of Jesus vaccinate him in the mighty name of Jesus. He will not die but live to declare the works of the living God. Yes, even if you don't like him, it doesn't matter. He's our leader right now. We need to pray for him. Mariba Shakataria, Ebreke Sokoruba, we soak President Trump, his wife Melania, in the blood of Jesus. We soak their children in the blood of Jesus. The hand of Corona will not bury them. The hand of COVID-19 will not bury them in the mighty name of Jesus. He will survive it. He will recover in the name of Jesus. Remember the last time we prayed for Boris Johnson of United Kingdom. You remember we prayed for him and the Lord healed him. The Lord, because the Lord told us we should pray for him immediately because the hand of death wanted to snatch him. That the hand of death was standing by him. If you remember some of the people that were here, and God, within hours, there was a news that he had come out of coma. We bless his holy name. Right now, oh Lord, lay your hand of power on President Donald Trump. Father, heal him by your mighty power. Heal his wife by your mighty power. Let every symptom of COVID-19 disappear by the power and the blood of Jesus. Father, strengthen and empower him again in the mighty name of Jesus. But Father, after this infection, draw him closer to Jesus. Draw him closer to Jesus. I know, Father, you are saying something. I want you to draw President Donald Trump closer to Jesus. Let Jesus enter into him. Maraba Sakata. Let Jesus enter into his wife. Let Jesus enter into his children by the power in the blood of Jesus. Maraba Shakatariwa. Rebra Kasandaba. Wherever he is right now, Holy Ghost overshadow him. Blood of Jesus overshadow him. Holy Ghost overshadow him. Blood of Jesus overshadow him. In the name of Jesus, it shall be well with him. In the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you very much. It just came, it just dropped in my spirit right now that we should pray for him. It will not get worse in the mighty name of Jesus. It will get better by the power in the blood of Jesus. We also pray for Vice President Biden and his family. We soak them in the blood of Jesus. No evil shall befall them in the mighty name of Jesus. The hand of coronavirus will not touch them in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Father, we just want to bless your holy name. Osawaru Irene, you are welcome in the name of Jesus. Oh yes, well, it's good to pray for leaders because you don't know whether you yourself are going to be a leader one day. Hallelujah. And it's not everybody that is going to like you. So that those that don't like you, don't continue to swear for you. When you need their prayers, the Lord will touch them in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Father, we just want to bless your holy name because we know you have answered our prayers concerning your son, President Trump. And right now, we know that you have sent your angels to go and heal him, even where he is. Godwin James, you are welcome in the mighty name of Jesus. It shall be well with him by the power in the blood of Jesus. Hallelujah. You are welcome once again to this prayer meeting, the hour of deliverance power, all the way from Mountain of Fire Miracles Ministries, Tampa, Florida. We just bless God for what he's doing. Ambassador Kinsing Smart Odimba, you are welcome in the name of Jesus. We are at the final day of our deliverance program. And Latoya Marion, God bless you in the name of Jesus. You're welcome. Please keep on sharing. We are in the final day. For the past 5 days, we have been doing deliverance from financial embarrassment and confusion. And today, the Lord God is going to finish
that which he has started in your life, in my life, in your home, in my home, in your family, in my family, in your household, in my household, by his mighty power. In the mighty name of Jesus, as from today, you and your family will no longer experience financial embarrassment. In the mighty name of Jesus, I am saying it with the tongue of power. I am saying it with the tongue of fire, that as from today, you and your family, you and your household, I and my family, I and my household will never again, throughout the rest of our lives, for the rest of our lives, we will never again experience financial embarrassment. In the mighty name of Jesus, for the Lord will continually supply all our needs according to his riches in glory by Christ Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus, from today, you will no longer, never again will you suffer lack again. In the mighty name of Jesus, never again will you be embarrassed financially. In the mighty name of Jesus, Makasi Kaliboria. Thank you, Jesus. They went to Jesus. How can the King of glory be embarrassed? They went to Jesus. They said, Jesus, aren't you and your disciples going to pay tax? They went to Jesus. Mommy Caroline Wood, you are welcome. They went to Jesus. They said, Jesus, you must pay tithe. You must pay today. Teto, Lato, Kume, you are welcome in the name. You will no longer be embarrassed again. They wanted to embarrass Jesus. Fred Naughty, you are welcome in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Whenever you are looking for money, it will miraculously appear to you in the mighty name of Jesus. Whenever you are looking for money, wherever you are looking for wealth, wherever you are looking for riches, it will miraculously appear in your life. Peters, Susan, you are welcome in the name of Jesus. Keep on sharing. They went to Jesus. Hallelujah. They got to Jesus. Then Jesus, is it not lawful for you to pay tax? Hallelujah. He now said, why not? He said, give unto Caesar what belongs to Caesar. Judas Iscariot. What? Stella Kimani, you are welcome. How much do we have in the purse? Nothing. Nothing. No money. Say, okay. Peter, you are the fisherman here. There's an ATM in the sea. It's called a fish. Somebody said, the Lord will give you the wealth of the seas by the power in the blood of Jesus. The Lord will give you the wealth of the seas by the power in the blood of Jesus. The Lord will give unto you the wealth of the seas. The wealth of the seas. The increase of the seas shall be given to you by the power in the blood of Jesus. The sea is the richest. The sea is the richest place on earth with treasures. I'm a geologist by profession. How do I know that? All the rocks, igneous, metamorphic, sedimentary, they all weather. They carry all the minerals. They carry all the treasures. When they wither, what happens? Rain comes, erosion, it erodes them and takes them where? To the sea. Somebody's here. I connect you to the wealth of the seas by the power in the blood of Jesus. I connect you to the wealth of the seas by the power in the blood of Jesus. Every wealth that is in the sea, I connect. Look at ordinary fish. Peter went to the fish, to the sea. Jesus told him, the first fish you catch, open the mouth. What we need is there. An ATM in the sea. Somebody say, I connect you to the ATM that is in the sea by the power in the blood of Jesus. I connect you to the ATM that is in the sea by the power in the blood of Jesus. I connect you to the ATM that is in the sea by the power in the blood of Jesus. And Peter caught the fish. Iyabo, Agbanadruwai, you are welcome in the name of Jesus. Keep on sharing. He caught the fish and found money inside the fish. Who put it there? Heaven will surprise you. Heaven will surprise you. Heaven will pleasantly surprise you. And those that want to embarrass you, heaven will disgrace them In the name of Jesus. Those that want to financially embarrass you, heaven will disgrace them. In the mighty name of Jesus, heaven will disgrace them by the power in the blood of Jesus. Let us go into the Bible. Deeper into the Bible. And see what is happening in the lives of men and women. I pray for somebody here. Financial crisis will not push you into destroying yourself. In the name of Jesus, financial crisis will not push you into destroying yourself. In the name of Jesus, financial crisis will not push you into destroying yourself. In the name of Jesus, financial crisis will not push you into destroying yourself. In the name of Jesus. Somebody says you want to destroy yourself. Don't try it. Don't try it. Don't try it. If you do, you are going to hellfire. Don't try. If you hurt yourself, if you do it, the Lord says, I tell you, don't try it. Don't hurt yourself. Your time has come. Your time has come. Yes, it has taken years. It has taken decades. But your time has come. Yes, heaven brought you to this prayer meeting. You are thinking of harming yourself. You are thinking of destroying yourself. But you say, let me go and listen to that man again. The fish that heaven has allocated to carry your wealth. Hallelujah. It's at the harbor right now. In the name of Jesus. That fish is vomiting your wealth. It's vomiting your riches. It's vomiting your wealth. It's vomiting your riches. It's vomiting your wealth. It's vomiting your riches. Yes. Masakata rababa leporia. Rabashakata rika. Raina saila kuria. Bore masakata rababa leporia. Bore baba kashe. Don't kill yourself. Because your wealth has come. Because your riches has come. Hallelujah. Let us look at the Bible. Amen. The Lord will help us in the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Hey, I say some women were cooking their children for food because of famine, because of financial hardship. You can see how financial hardship can push a man or a woman to destroy himself or herself. No wonder Psalm 125 verse 3 says, the Lord will not allow the rod of the wicked to rest upon the lot of the righteous, so that the righteous will not dip their hands into iniquity. Sometimes financial embarrassment is the rod of the wicked. Somebody's here, every power that is using the rod of financial embarrassment to chastise you, to flog you, they shall die by thunder in the name of Jesus. They shall die by thunder in the name of Jesus. Every power that is using the rod of financial embarrassment, the rod of financial confusion to chastise you, to flog you, they shall die by thunder. They shall die by thunder. They shall die by thunder in the name of Jesus. Let's go into the Bible. The Bible says in Second Kings, very interesting. You know, thank God for the word of God. There's nothing you are going through right now that is not here in the Bible. Yes, and God has written these things down so that you can see that there is hope for you. In Job chapter 14, verse 7, the Bible says there's a hope. There's hope for a tree. If it be cut down at the scent of water, it shall spring up again. It doesn't matter. Even if they have cut you down before now, at the scent of water, and who is that water? Jesus Christ is the water of life. At the scent of the water of life, the Lord Jesus Christ, you will spring up again by the power in the blood of Jesus. Somebody said they have killed your finances, they buried it. But I bless God, because during this 1 week of financial deliverance, from financial embarrassment, your finance has been delivered. Your finance has been delivered. Your finance has been delivered. Every witchcraft barrier on your finance has been destroyed by the power in the blood of Jesus. Every witchcraft barrier on your finances has been destroyed by the power in the blood of Jesus. Look at what happened here. How hardship can push men and women to destroy themselves. A lot of people have committed suicide because of financial hardship. Hallelujah. And like I said, they see somebody's on this line, they want you to commit suicide
because of financial hardship. You will blame yourself if you do it. Because when you go, Hope Gideon, you're welcome. You will see the wealth you killed yourself for is actually at the door. The wealth has been delivered. It's at the door now. It's just for you to open the door and collect it. The divine postman that has been dispatched to bring your wealth and riches has brought it already. It's at your door. I'm looking at it. I'm looking at the way he's delivering it. He's at your door right now. Hallelujah. I'm saying it again. Within the next 3 weeks, you will see what is going to happen in your life. Oh, yes. Because your wealth and riches have already been dispatched. Arm of grace, you are welcome in the name of Jesus. God bless you in the name of Jesus. Thank you very much. Hallelujah. It has already been delivered. Amen. And that is why heaven brought you here. Helen, again, you are welcome in the name of Jesus. Good afternoon from here. Hallelujah. But look at what happened here. The Lord will help us. In the name of, in 2 Kings chapter 6, from verse 24, wonders shall never end. And it came to pass after this that Ben-Hadad, king of Syria, gathered all his hosts and went up and besieged Samaria. You see this satanic bewitchment, besiege again. Amen. But the satanic siege, you can see it again. What they did to Israel, what the Amalekites and the Midianites did to Israel, and they became poor, they became impoverished. You can see now, King Ben-Hadad of Syria is doing it again to Samaria. Amen. Whenever they want to embarrass you, they lay a siege on you. I pray for you again. Every siege of darkness that has been programmed to make you poor, I command them to scatter by the power in the blood of Jesus. Every siege of darkness that has been programmed to make you poor, to make your spouse poor, to make your family poor, to make me poor, to make my wife poor, to make my family poor, I command it to scatter by the power in the blood of Jesus. I command it to scatter by the power in the blood of Jesus. I command it to scatter by the power in the blood. That's what they do. When they want to embarrass you, what do? They enclose you in so that nothing comes in and nothing goes out. Remember the wall of Jericho. Nothing comes in. As somebody said, every wall of Jericho that household wickedness has built against your finances, I command it to scatter by the power in the blood of Jesus. Every wall of Jericho that household wickedness has built against your finances, I say scatter by the power in the blood of Jesus. Scatter by the power in the blood of Jesus. Because you see, when they build that kind of wall, nothing comes in. Nothing goes out. Amen. Jane Way, God bless you in the name of... Go and ask Dead Sea. Why do they call Dead Sea, Dead Sea? Nothing flows in, nothing flows out. When nothing flows in and nothing flows out, everything will be dead. Ha! Somebody say a simple prayer. Say, any power that wants to turn my life into a Dead Sea, you are a liar. Fall down and die in the name of Jesus. Every power that wants to turn... There's a sister here shouting loud. Every power that wants to turn my life into a Dead Sea, that wants to turn my wife's life into a Dead Sea, that wants to turn my children's lives into Dead Sea, you are a liar. That backfire, that backfire, that backfire, that backfire, that backfire, that backfire, that backfire. Be angry in your spirit. Every power that wants nothing to flow into my life, that wants nothing to flow out of my life, that wants to turn me into a Dead Sea, fall down and die by the power in the blood of Jesus. Fall down. So King Ben-Hadad of Syria gathered all his host. They went up and they besieged Samaria. Every committee of darkness, every association of wicked powers, every committee of darkness, every association of wicked powers that have besieged your destiny, that have besieged your finances, that have besieged your home, I command them to scatter unto desolation by the power in the blood of Jesus. I command them to scatter by the power in the blood of Jesus. I will tell you the implication of this. When they besiege you like this, they will not allow your divine helpers to connect to you. They will not allow those that are supposed to support you to come near you. Amen. You are going to say
every siege of darkness that has disconnected me from my divine helpers. Every siege of darkness. There's a brother here. A brother and two sisters. Every siege of darkness that has disconnected me from my divine helpers, I command you to scatter in the name of Jesus. I command you to scatter in the name of Jesus. I command you to scatter every witchcraft siege. Every witchcraft siege that has disconnected me from my divine helpers, scatter by the power in the blood of Jesus. Scatter by the power in the blood of Jesus. Scatter by the power in the blood of Jesus. Scatter by the power in the blood of Jesus. Scatter by the power in the blood of Jesus. Scatter by the power in the blood of Jesus. Scatter by the power in the blood of Jesus. Yes. That's one of the things that the siege of darkness does. When they mount a siege of darkness around you, nothing comes in. Nothing goes out. You can't go out for help. You can't receive help from outside. This is what is happening to somebody here. You need to pray. Every siege of darkness that is limiting my greatness, scatter by thunder in the name of Jesus. Every siege of darkness limiting my greatness, limiting my prosperity, limiting my wife and my children's greatness and prosperity, scatter by the power in the blood of Jesus. Scatter by the power in the blood of Jesus. Scatter by the power in the blood of Jesus. Scatter by the power in the blood of Jesus. I told you, whenever there's a siege, there'll be poverty. Whenever there's a siege, amen, there'll be lack. Wherever there's a siege, there'll be hunger. Wherever there's a siege, amen, there'll be famine, there'll be drought. The siege of darkness. I'm telling you, there are some people, there are men and women, it's not that God has not blessed them, but they have laid a siege around them so that they cannot move. They cannot get to where they can meet their helpers. They have put a siege. They have put a fort around them. They have put a barrier, a wall around them, like the wall of Jericho. But the Lord will have mercy on you and scatter every wall of darkness that the devil has built against you in the name of Jesus. That's why the psalmist said, he said, by him, by thee, O Lord, do I run through a troop. He said, by my God, do I live over a wall. Which wall? Which troop? That is the siege. The siege. They have put a siege around your marriage, your marital life. They don't want you to meet the man, the woman that heaven has commissioned to marry you. That seed shall scatter by the power in the blood of Jesus. Every siege of darkness that will not allow you to meet the man you are meant to marry, to meet the woman you are meant to marry, to meet the men and women that are meant to help your business shall scatter by the power. The seed shall scatter by the power in the blood of Jesus. The seed shall scatter by the power in the blood of Jesus. It's one of the strategies of the kingdom of darkness. So when things are happening in your life and you are wondering, why are things going like this? Sometimes it's this siege. They have isolated you. They have put you in a siege. Even the people that want to help you, occasionally when they come, they help you, they run away. Because the power of that siege will attack them. People have called me before. They help people and they run into trouble. Why? Because the powers that have decided that they will suffer now started attacking their helpers. Somebody is here. This is your story. I want you to shout it like a wounded lion. Say, powers attacking my divine helpers. Powers attacking my divine helpers. What are you waiting for? Fall down and die. In the name of Jesus, every power attacking my divine helpers, fall down and die. For in Jesus' name, let's carry on. 2 Kings chapter 6, verse 25. And there was a great famine in Samaria. Why won't there be famine when they have laid a siege on Samaria?
every siege in your life that is causing famine, every siege in your life that is causing poverty, every siege in your life that is causing failure, I command it to catch fire and burn to ashes in the name of Jesus. I command it to catch fire and burn to ashes in the name of Jesus. I command it to catch fire and burn to ashes in the name of Jesus. I command it to catch fire and burn to ashes in the name of every siege of darkness in your life that has brought poverty, that has brought failure, that has brought stagnancy, that has brought demotion, that has brought lack of promotion, lack of progress, I command it to catch fire by the power in the blood of Jesus. I command it to catch fire by the power in the blood of Jesus. I command it to catch fire by the power in the blood. So you are understanding the nitty-gritty of spirituality. When you say somebody is under attack, you know, you wonder, what do they mean by attack? What kind of attack? This is the kind of attack. In the spirit realm, in the invisible. So, you know, you see a man or a woman, they are walking freely. They are moving about. Meanwhile, they are under siege. They are under siege. There's a sister here. You are under the siege of witchcraft powers. I can see them. I can see the way they have surrounded you. And the way it is, to be honest with you, in another 40 years, nothing good is going to happen in your life. But today, your story changes. Every siege of witchcraft powers in your life, I command them to scatter and die in the name of Jesus. Every siege of witchcraft powers in your life, I command them to scatter and die in the name of Jesus. Every siege of witchcraft powers in your life, I say scatter, I say die, 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 I say scatter, I say die. In the name of, this is what they do. Like Ben-Hadad. And his host. They gather their host against you. They stop any good thing that is coming into your life. Every satanic checkpoint that the wicked has erected against your greatness shall scatter by thunder in the name of Jesus. Every satanic checkpoint that the wicked has erected against your greatness, against your prosperity, against your promotion, against your wealth and your riches, they shall scatter by the thunder fire of the living God. They shall scatter by the thunder fire of the living God. They shall scatter by the thunder fire of the living God. They shall scatter by the thunder fire of the living God. For in Jesus' name we pray. Hallelujah. That's why you see some people. They are working very hard. They are doing everything. But nothing is working. Nothing. God bless you, sir. It is well with you. They are talking to me. Hallelujah. Nothing is working. But every siege, I pray it again, every siege of wickedness upon your life shall catch fire, burn to ashes, shall catch fire, burn to ashes, shall catch fire, burn to ashes. In the name of Jesus, keep on sharing. Don't forget to invite 14 people into this prayer meeting. You can see how wickedness operates in the lives of men and women. And look at, the Bible says, amen. And there was a great famine in Samaria. And behold, they besieged it until an ass head was sold for four score pieces of silver. The head of a donkey was selling, amen, for about 80 pieces of silver, which was that hyperinflation. You see, they cause inflation. Hallelujah. Every power causing inflation in your life shall fall down and die by the power in the blood of Jesus. Every power that is causing inflation in your life, that is causing spiritual inflation in your life, they shall be wasted by thunder in the name of Jesus. They cause inflation. The head of a donkey was sold for 80 pieces of silver, and the fourth part of a cap of dove's dung, the sheet of dove, the feces of dove. Ah. May you never be pushed into a situation where you will eat scraps in the mighty name of Jesus. May you never be pushed into a situation that you begin to eat scraps, that you begin to eat rubbish in the mighty name of Jesus. They were eating doni, Adedokun, Adejare. You are welcome in the name of Jesus. I pray for you.
May you never be pushed to the level where you begin to eat scraps. You begin to eat dungs in the mighty name of Jesus. The enemy will not turn you into a scavenger in the mighty name of Jesus. As somebody said, I pray for you. The enemy will not turn you and your family into scavengers in the mighty name of Jesus. The enemy will not turn me and my family into scavengers in the mighty name of... You don't know a scavenger. Scavengers, they go on top of, on dung hills. Looking for waste. They pick waste to eat. Scavengers. They are scavenging. Some people are not necessarily going to a physical dunghill, but the way they are living their lives, they are scavengers. Somebody say, I pray for you. Any witch in your father's house that has decided, Oyegoke Nathaniel, you are welcome in the name of Nasuma Dimo, you are welcome in the name of Jesus. Keep on sharing. God bless you in the name of Jesus. Any witch in your father's house that wants to turn you into a scavenger shall be wasted by thunder in the mighty name of Jesus. Barnabas, talk. You are welcome in the name of Jesus. Any witch in your father's house, any wizard in your father's house that wants to turn you into a scavenger, Lily Amaka Ulasi, you are welcome in the name of Jesus. Any witch, any wizard in your father's house that wants to turn you into a scavenger shall fall down and die in the name of Jesus. They shall fall down and die. I want you to pray for yourself now. You better pray. Do you know what it means to be a scavenger? That means you are just eating anything you see. I reject it in the name of Jesus. I reject it in the name of powers that want to turn me and my family into scavengers. You are a liar. Die by the power in the blood of Jesus. Any power that wants to turn me, my wife and my children, my brothers, my sisters, into scavengers. You are a liar. That backfire. 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 In the name of Jesus. That's the kind of prayer you pray with fire. A lot of people are scavengers right now. A lot of people are going about begging for bread. That's what it means. When you begin to beg, if you are using credit card and your monthly wage is not enough, you are a scavenger. You don't understand. If your credit is destroyed, you cannot buy anything. They've turned you into a scavenger. Amen. Power! They want to turn me into a scavenger. You are a liar. That backfire. That backfire. That backfire. That backfire. That backfire. That backfire. In the name of Jesus. I hope you are dry fasting today. Remember, it's our palm of St. John's tomorrow. And thank God, it was not planned. Today is a day of fasting. Today is a day of prayer. Every agenda of scavenging that the wicked has programmed for your life, I command it to scatter by the power in the blood of Jesus. Every agenda of scavenging that the enemy has programmed into your life, into your home, into your family, I say scatter by the power in the blood of Jesus. I say scatter by the power in the blood of Jesus. I want you to share this meeting with 14 people. I want you to do a watch party right now with this meeting. There are millions of scavengers, but the Lord did not make them like that. It was the siege of darkness that turned them into scavengers. Malabushika Yababa. Somebody say, I want you to pray. Malika, say, every siege of darkness that wants to turn me and my family into scavengers, scatter by thunder in the name of Jesus. Every siege of darkness that wants to turn me and my family into scavengers, into paupers, I say, scatter by the power in the blood of Jesus. I say, scatter by the power in the blood of Jesus. I say, scatter by the power. In the blood of Jesus. You don't understand. Well, wicked powers want to be wicked. Somebody was doing business. Business was doing very well. Somebody came to him and said, I can help you to boost your business. And the man said, no problem. I won't mention names. The moment the stranger entered into the business, bankrupted the business. Almost turned the business owner that was doing very well into a scavenger. You don't understand. Every siege of darkness that wants to convert your destiny into a scavenger, they shall be wasted by thunder. 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 I reject scavenging. The spirit of a scavenger, I reject it by the power in the blood of Jesus. I will not beg for bread. My wife and my children will not beg for bread. For our God, the Lord Jesus Christ, is our sufficiency. In the mighty, there are a lot of scavengers. And you see what is happening. It's a siege of darkness. When there's a siege of darkness on you, you cannot get job. When there's a siege of darkness on you, you cannot get loan. When there's a siege of darkness, you can't get anything. Because there's a siege. Somebody is here. You have been looking for a loan to do a very big business. But nobody is giving to you. It's the siege. For the next 7 days, you are going to pray. Just one prayer. Every siege of darkness that is blocking my access to funds, scattered by the power in the blood of Jesus. Every siege of darkness that is blocking my access to funds, scattered by the power. That's what the prayer you need to pray for 7 days. 7 nights. 1 hour every night for 7 days. You are looking for loan to do a big business, a big project. But nobody's giving it to you. You have gone everywhere. You can't get. And this, you know it. If you do this project, even your children's children will benefit from it. But you see, they want to dry it up. At the end, the power that wants to dry up that project shall dry up and die in the name of Jesus. The power that wants to dry up your project shall dry up and die by the power in the blood of Jesus. A siege. So when they put a siege of darkness on you, that's, they really want to embarrass you. They want to embarrass you financially. So that nobody can help you. No means. No way out. No access. Everything blocked. Siege. Somebody said, every siege of darkness on your marriage shall scatter by the power in the blood of Jesus. Every siege of darkness on your marriage, on your career, on your job, on your business shall scatter by the power in the blood of Jesus. Every siege of darkness on your finances shall scatter by the power in the blood of Jesus. Hallelujah. Let's continue. They were buying the head of a donkey. They were buying the feces of doves. Jesus is Lord. Eating the feces of doves. Financial embarrassment. Amen. In my language, where I came from, they said, when the wicked begins to deal with a man, when they finish with him, he will see ordinary paper on the floor. He will call it, he said, this is money. Which means they will so financially deal with him that ordinary paper will look like money to him. Whosoever is planning that for you shall be wasted in the mighty name of Jesus. The merciless fire of God shall burn them to ashes. In any power that wants your finances to fail so that you can be financially embarrassed shall be wasted by the power in the blood of Jesus. Any power that wants your finances to fail so that you can be financially embarrassed, they shall be wasted by the thunder fire of the living God. Let's continue to read. Verse 26. 2 Kings chapter 6, verse 26. And as the king of Israel was passing upon the wall, there cried the woman unto him. Look at the strange things that financial hardship can cause. Hallelujah. Somebody said, the Lord will deliver you from financial hardship. Henry Ambrose, you are welcome in the name of Jesus. The Lord will deliver you from financial hardship. Nasuma Dimo, you are welcome in the name of Jesus. I say the Lord will deliver you from financial hardship. What you are calling hardship that's not hardship. That's not hardship. When you see people that are in finance, they sell their children. May you never go into financial hardship. In the mighty name of Jesus. When you see people that have financial hardship, they sell their children, they sell their house, they sell their car. There's nothing they don't sell. They won't sell their body organs.
There are some countries in the world right now. The people are so poor. They say they are selling their kidney. They sell their kidney. They sell their daughters in early marriage. Financial hardship. Malika Suri Baba Kaskendeye. Romanis Kalepori Baba. I pray for you. I pray again in this prayer meeting. Every power that wants to push you into financial hardship shall be buried by the fire of the Holy Ghost in the name of Jesus. They shall be buried by the fire of the Holy Ghost in the name of Jesus. They shall be buried by the fire of the Holy Ghost in the name of Jesus. They shall be buried by the fire of the Holy Ghost in the mighty name of Jesus. The Bible says, and as the king of Israel was passing by upon the wall, there cried a woman unto him, saying, help my lord, O king. As he said, if the Lord do not help thee, whence shall I help thee? If God cannot help you, how can I help you? I'm just ordinary king. Eh? Look at what the woman said. Amen. When shall I help you? Out of the barn floor or out of the wine spread? And the king said unto her, what aileth thee? And she answered, may you never be pushed into a situation where you will sell what is precious to you in the mighty name of Jesus. May you never be pushed into a situation where you will begin to destroy your own self. In the name of Jesus. A lot of women are into prostitution now. Men and women into prostitution now because of hardship. Financial hardship. And they are selling their body and they are destroying their bodies. They will sleep with all manner people that have COVID-19, they will sleep with them. People that have HIV, they will sleep with them. People that have chlamydia, they will sleep with them. People that have all manner of disease, they cannot say no. Because of financial hardship. Every power that wants to push you into a situation where you begin to destroy yourself, let such powers fall down and die in the name of Jesus. Let such powers fall down and die in the name of Jesus. Let such powers fall down and die. Look at what Ben-Hadad did to Samaria. The Bible says, listen up. Amen. This woman said unto me, and she answered, that's the woman, and she answered, this woman said unto me, give thy son that we may eat him today. We may eat your son because of hunger. Because of hunger, man-made hunger. Because of Ben-Hadad, the king of Syria. They were eating their babies in Samaria. Every satanic king that wants you to eat your babies shall be wasted in the name of Jesus. Every satanic king that wants you to eat your children shall be wasted in the name of Jesus. Every satanic king that wants you to eat your children shall be wasted in the name of Jesus. Every satanic king that wants you to eat your children, they shall be wasted. 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 I've heard it before. A man was so poor, he didn't know what to do. He went to a herbalist and said, herbalist, I'm too poor. I can't continue like this. I know you can make me rich. Do something about my situation. Herbalist said, no problem. The only price is that you will use one of your children. He said, one of my children? He said, you have about 7. What is the big deal if you use one? Any situation in my life that will make me to use my children, die in the name of Jesus. Any situation in my life that will make me to use my children, die in the name of Jesus. Any situation in my life that will make me to use my children for sacrifice, die by the power
in the blood of Jesus. Die by the power in the blood of Jesus. Any situation in my life, in my wife, in my children's lives that will make us to use our children for sacrifice, die by the power in the blood of Jesus. Any situation that will make us to say, no, that one should go while the others remain, die in the name of Jesus. Die. For in Jesus' name, pray. You are understanding it now. What is going on in our world? A man that went to do money rituals and has used one of his own son or daughter has technically eaten the child. After all, he's going to eat the money. He's going to eat from the money. So indirectly, he's eating the child. Heavenly Abana, God bless you in the name of Jesus. Pray this prayer. Anyone that wants to use my children for sacrifice, fall down and die by the power in the blood of Jesus. Anyone that wants to use my, don't say it does not concern you, better open your mouth and pray now. Anyone that is planning to use my children for sacrifice, fall down and die by the power in the blood of Jesus. Anyone that is planning to use my children for sacrifice, fall down and die. For in Jesus' name, of course, when things are normal, everything will be normal. Is when things become abnormal, that abnormal things begin to happen. In Samaria, before King Ben-Hadad of Syria came to besiege the land of Samaria, they didn't have any problem. They were eating well, everybody was doing fine. But the moment that king came and put a siege, Timmy, Totter, you are welcome in the name of Jesus. Keep on sharing. God bless you in the name of Jesus. The moment King Ben-Hadad came and put a siege, they were hitting the head of donkey. They were hitting the feces of those. They now graduated to eating their children. Somebody is looking at me right now. Don't joke with this prayer. Those that want to eat my children, die! In the name of Jesus, powers that want to eat my children, die in the name of Jesus. Any power that wants to eat my children, die in the name of Jesus. Any power that wants to eat my children, die in the name of Jesus. Any power that wants to eat my children, die in the name of Jesus. Any power that wants to eat my children, you better pray now. I will tell you how things happen sometimes. A man who is married and have children, may be a good man, may not be an evil man, but because he's going through financial embarrassment, he will now meet friends that are occultic. That's how it happens. He will now meet friends that are occultic. That's why you need to pray. When they ask you to pray, don't say it does not concern me, because you don't know what can happen. A good man can meet a bad man, and they begin to sell evil ideas to him. Most of the people that joined occultism, they were not bad men. They were not evil men. Amen. Some of them were tricked into it. Some of them, out of desperation, joined these occultic groups. And of course, when they now join, they want to be rich. They want to end financial embarrassment in their lives. Everybody is looking at them. All these years, you have been working, you have traveled, you have done this, you are doing business, nothing is working. Sometimes it's the people that is the problem. They are making jest of him. Why don't you leave the man alone and let him wait for his time, for God's time, for God, you know, for God's speed for his life? But they keep on troubling him, until they push her into doing evil things. Hallelujah. And also, for spouses that are always demanding, you know that your husband does not have a thing, you keep on demanding for what he does not have, you are going to push him into occultism. Manage what he has. Manage what she has, so that the world will not capture his soul. So by the time they join this group, Of course, it is the occult group that is going to be asking for their children. It is rampant right now. It's happening nearly everywhere. I will not deceive you. This is why you need to pray. There is so much financial embarrassment in the land. There is so much financial hardship in the land. In fact, I was hearing, they were telling me, I won't mention the country now, where some Yahoo Yahoo boys are carrying women's underwear for money rituals. Women underwear to tell you how desperate. And these are young boys. These are very young boys carrying women's underwear. Before, they were carrying women's sanitary pad. They don't even need that anymore. I think they are fetish doctors. Their witch doctors have gone a little bit more technical. You don't need to, even the people that are carrying human beings for sacrifice, those ones are still using crude technology. Right now, they don't need to carry any human being. They don't need to carry, all they need is the pant of the woman. See what is happening. Is it not the same with the people that are eating their babies? Right now, a lot of people all over the world, they are eating human beings. Eating. By way of rituals, ritual killings, and all manner of things. If you get any money from ritual killing, you use that money to buy food, you are eating a human being. That's the truth. Because that money is from that human being. So you are eating a human being. If you use a child, you are eating that child. That's what it means. The Bible says, amen. And she answered, this woman said unto me, give thy son that we may eat him today, and we will eat my son tomorrow. So we boiled my son, Jesus is Lord, and did eat him. The Lord will deliver you from financial embarrassment. Anything that will make you to sell your children, Elizabeth, we are fully, you are welcome. May the fire of God destroy it. In the name of Jesus, anything that will make you to sell your children, let the fire of God destroy it now. In the name of Jesus, anything that will make you to, you better say powerful amen. You don't know why we are praying this prayer. Don't ever say it cannot be me. Just say amen. When you are here, seven powerful amen. I pray for you again. Anything that will make you to sell your children, any financial hardship that will make you to sell your children, let it die now by the power in the blood of Jesus. Any financial hardship that will make you to sell your children, let it die now by the power in the blood of Jesus. So we boiled my son and did eat him. And I said unto her on the next day, give thy son that we may eat him. And She had hid her son. She ate another person's son who wants her own son to die. Hallelujah. And it came to pass, excuse me, verse 30. And it came to pass when the king heard the words of the woman that he rent his clothes. He was still joking initially. Am I God? Am I the Lord? When he had not heard what the woman wanted to tell him. He was passing on the wall. He said, yes, why are you asking me for help? If God does not help you, how can I help you? Woman said, wait now, let me tell you. When I finish telling you, you will know that you need to help me. Hallelujah. The Bible says, and it came to pass, when the king heard the words of the woman, that he rent his clothes, and he passed by upon the wall, and the people looked, and behold, he had sackcloth within upon his flesh. The king that was wearing a royal robe, the moment he had that news, everything turned into sackcloth. But what caused all this? The women didn't have enough money to even buy the dung of dove, the feces of dove. They didn't have money. The Bible says money answered all things. I pray for you today. You will never lack money. In the name of Jesus, you will never lack money. Money will not push you to destroy what you do. Will not push you into what will destroy you. In the name of Jesus, money will not push you into what will destroy you. In the name of Jesus, money will not push your children into what will destroy them. In the name of Jesus, money will not push your husband into what will destroy him. In the name of Jesus, money will not push your wife into what will destroy her. In the name of Jesus, money will not push your children into what will destroy them. In the name of Jesus. Is it not money that is pushing a lot of people into prostitution? Is it not money that is pushing a lot of people to push hard drugs? I went to Malaysia about 3-4 years ago. I was there for 1 month to minister. He told her, Kesemi, Kalimo, you are welcome in the name of Jesus. And I was told a lot of people in prison yard on death toll. Obo, Betty, you are welcome in the name of Jesus. Why? Because they pushed hard drugs. A lot of people on death roll because they pushed hard drug. What made them to push hard drug? Amen. Some of them, they want to avoid financial embarrassment. Even though for some of them it's long truth. Some of them want to be rich, which is absolutely not necessary. But for some of them, it's difficult. When you hear some of their stories, some of them will tell you their wife had cancer. They are asking for millions of naira. Millions of this, millions of that, and they don't know what to do. They go into robbery. They go into pushing hard drugs. But you can see how financial embarrassment, financial hardship can push a man or a woman into destruction. For those ones I heard about their story in Malaysia, of course, they were going to slaughter them because of money. A brother was telling us a story. It was strange. A brother was telling a story. He said, somebody had carried drugs and there was drug in his house and police got wind of it and they went into that house to arrest the brother. But while he was there, there was another brother who was innocent that didn't even know that brother or that man was a drug pusher. He was in the house, but unfortunately, he didn't have the documents of the land of that country. He immediately heard police. They were on like 6th floor. He jumped down and he died. He jumped down and he died. He didn't know anything about drugs. He was just at the wrong place at the wrong time. When he had police, he thought they were coming to arrest him because he didn't have documents. Not knowing that the man he went to visit was the suspect that they feel was pushing drugs and they were coming to arrest. The moment he saw police, he ran through the balcony and jumped into his death. What money will do. Even the hand of money, even the power of money, may not be able to solve it. The problem that money will cause, or to woman dasai afaima lapa owolika. The problem that money will cause in this world, not even the power of money will be able to solve it. That's why we have to be very prayerful. That's why we have to be prayerful all the time. Hallelujah. Amen. But we thank God, because in that same story, in 2 Kings chapter 7 from verse 1 to 2, because somebody is here, today is the final day of this deliverance. The God of by this time tomorrow will visit you. In the mighty name of Jesus, the God of by this time tomorrow, the God that has delivered you in this deliverance program, the God of by this time tomorrow, he will visit you by his mighty power. And of course, the Bible says in 2 Kings chapter 7, verse 1 to 2, a continuation of that story. Then Elisha said,
Hear ye the word of the Lord. Thus said the Lord, tomorrow about this time shall a measure, tomorrow about this time shall a measure of fine flour be sold for a shekel. Of course, when it got to women now eating their children, the king of Samaria was now desperately looking for Elisha. So they found Elisha. Joy Chooks, you are welcome. So they found Elisha to come and do something about it. Hallelujah. And of course, Elisha came. Amen. And first of all, was abusing the king. You are the cause of this problem. You are an idol worshiper. You are this, you are that. But anyway, they settled their squabbles. And eventually, Elisha agreed to pray for the land. And the Bible says, then Elisha said, hear the word of the Lord. Thus saith the Lord. Somebody is here. You are hearing it now. Thus saith the Lord. Amen. Tomorrow, about this time, shall a measure of fine flour be sold for a shekel, and two measures of barley for a shekel in the gate of Samaria. Hallelujah. The God that you have come to see on this prayer platform, the God that you have been praying with since we started on Monday, the God of by this time tomorrow, that God will pleasantly surprise you in the mighty name of Jesus. Somebody is here. I pray and prophesy that you are believing God for something. The God of by this time tomorrow will make you to have that thing within the next 3 days in the mighty name of Jesus. Titila, your money, sir. God bless you, man. You are welcome. Helen Igene, you are welcome in the name of Jesus. The God of by this time tomorrow will hand over to you that thing you have been believing God for in the mighty name of Jesus. Fatu Bangura, God bless you in the name of Jesus. Ife Jesus, God bless you in the name of Jesus. I said the God of by this time tomorrow will visit you in the name of Jesus. You have been in this deliverance program now for the past 1 week. It is 1 week today. The God of by this time tomorrow, the God that we have been calling for the past 1 week, by the power in the blood of Jesus, shall visit you by fire, 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 shall visit you by fire. And it will arrest every source of financial embarrassment in your life. In the name of Jesus. Pray this prayer. Say, oh God of by this time tomorrow. Oh God of by this time tomorrow. Arrest every source of financial embarrassment in my life. In the mind, don't joke with that prayer. Though it's a prophetic prayer. Oh God of by this time tomorrow, arrest every source of financial embarrassment in my life, in my wife's life, in my children's lives, in my home, in my family, in my household, in the name of Jesus. Oh God of by this time tomorrow, arise in your power and arrest every source of financial embarrassment in my life, in my wife, in my children, in the name of Jesus. Arise in your power and destroy every source of financial confusion in my life, in my wife, in my children, by the power in the blood of Jesus. Oh God, arise and destroy them now in the mighty name of Jesus. I cannot continue like this. My story must change now. My story must change today. Oh God, or by this time tomorrow, arrest every source of financial embarrassment in my life. For in Jesus' name we have prayed. Hallelujah. Amen. I pray for you now. You have prayed for the past 1 week. Some of you have been fasting. Some of you dry fast. Some of you fruit fast. Some of you ordinary fast. But I prophesy into your life that starting from this very moment, the garment of financial embarrassment that you have worn all your life, today, I collect it from you and I throw it into fire in the name of Jesus. I collect it from you, I throw it into fire In the mighty name of Jesus. From today, you will no longer wear the garment of financial embarrassment. In the mighty name of Jesus. Money will come to you miraculously. In the name of Jesus. Peter went to the sea and saw money in the mouth of the fish. You will see money in strange places by the power in the blood of Jesus. You will see money in strange places by the power in the blood of Jesus. The Bible says, I will give unto you the treasures of darkness. From today, treasures of darkness shall be given to you in the name of Jesus. The treasure that you have never seen before, the treasure that no one has ever seen before in your father's house shall be given to you. You shall see it, shall be given to you. You shall see it, shall be given to you. You shall see it by the power in the blood of Jesus. The treasures of darkness, they call it the treasure of darkness because no one can see it. It's only those that God has opened their eyes that can see the treasures of darkness. From today, by the power in the blood of Jesus, the treasures of darkness that will feed you and feed your family from generation to generation, begin to see it now. By the power in the blood of Jesus, begin to locate it now. In the name of Jesus, the Lord will open your eyes. You will see the treasure of darkness that Jehovah has allocated to your destiny. In the name of Jesus, as from today, by the power in the blood of Jesus, the Lord will open your eyes. You will see the treasures of darkness that heaven has allocated to your destiny. You will see the hidden riches of secret places that Jehovah has allocated to your destiny in the mighty name of Jesus. For in Jesus' name we pray. Sometimes, the bereavement of opportunities, the bereavement of opportunities can put a man or a woman in the state of financial embarrassment. The Bible says, time and season happen to them all. The poor, the rich, time and season happen to them all. You don't understand. Every day, when I was looking at the story of Zuckerberg, I hope I pronounced the name very well, Zuckerberg, the Facebook man, they said he was looking at the yearbook, the school yearbook, where people have their faces, their addresses, and that was how he developed the Facebook. Amen. Time and season happen to them all. Hallelujah. Somebody has become a billionaire by converting yearbook into electronic Facebook. Hallelujah. The Lord will help us in the mighty name of Jesus. May you locate your own treasure of darkness in the name of Jesus. May you locate your own treasure of darkness, the treasure of darkness that heaven has allocated to you, that the throne of grace has allocated to you. May you locate it from today by the power in the blood of Jesus. Say, I, my wife, and my children shall locate our treasures of darkness from today by the power in the blood of Jesus. Father, where you have buried my wealth and my riches, Father, take me there by your mighty power in the mighty name of Jesus. Oh Lord, my Father, where you have buried my wealth and my riches, where you have buried my wife's wealth and riches, where you have buried my children's wealth and riches, Father, take us there by your mighty power. Father, take us there. Take my family there. Take my descendants there by your mighty power. Where you have buried our treasures, where you have buried our riches, where you have buried our wealth, Father, take us there. All we need is to know the place. We know that when we get the place, we will always get it. When we see it, we will always use it. Father, take us there by your mighty power. Father, take me there. I am tired of financial embarrassment. Somebody say, open your mouth and pray. I am tired of financial embarrassment. My Father, my God, to every man you have created, every man that you have created, there is a divine allocation of treasure, of hidden riches and secret places. Hidden riches and secret places. Father, take me there. Don't make it hidden again. Father, reveal it to me. Father, reveal my treasures of darkness. Father, reveal it to me. I am tired of this financial confusion. I am tired of this financial embarrassment. Father, take me to where you buried my treasures. In the name of Jesus. But in this prayer meeting, I pray for you. Where your treasure is buried, the Lord will take you there in the name of Jesus. Where your riches, your wealth, is hidden, the Lord will take you there. In the name of Jesus. You know, Jesus wanted to use the chamber of a man for the Last Supper. And Jesus told his disciples, he said, go. You will see a pitcher, a man that is carrying a jar of water on his head. He said, follow him anywhere he goes. Thank God that that man did not go to the toilet. Thank God that that man did not go to the farm. But that was Jesus talking anyway. The man couldn't have gone anywhere. The man became a signpost pointing to the direction. I pray for you today. You will meet men and women that will point you to the direction of your treasure. In the mighty name of Jesus, you will meet men and women that will take you to where your treasures are buried. In the mighty name of Jesus, the Lord will connect you to those that will connect you to your divine treasure. In the name of Jesus, the Lord will connect you to those that will connect you to your divine treasure. In the name of Jesus, the Lord will take you to them. The Lord will bring them to you. In the mighty name of Jesus, all those that heaven has appointed to take you to your treasure of darkness, they will locate you by fire. They will locate you by fire. They will locate you by fire. You are a rich man. You are a rich woman. You cannot continue like this in financial embarrassment. That is not the plan of God for you. Mariba Shukaliba, where your allocation is buried, the Lord will take you there by his mighty power. In the mighty name of Jesus, where your allocation is buried, the Lord will take you there by his mighty power. For in Jesus' name we pray. And I read the last part of that 2 Kings chapter 7. The Bible says, verse 2, Then a Lord, on whose hand the king leaned, answered the man of God, big mouth, because he was an officer, because the king was leaning on his hand. He think he can just talk anyhow, but he received his death sentence. Hallelujah. Anyone that will speak negatively against the deliverance that God has carried out in your life, they will fall down and die. In the name of Jesus, anyone that will challenge your deliverance, the deliverance that God has done for you in the past 1 week, the Lord will bury them. In the name of Jesus. Deliverance was taking place. Elisha has just announced the deliverance of Samaria. And somebody doubted it. He said, then a Lord on whose hand the king leaned answered the man of God and said, behold, if the Lord will make windows in heaven, even if God converts, make a mixed window in heaven, might this be? Can it happen? And he said, behold, Elisha quickly answered him, behold, thou shalt see it with thy eyes, but shalt not eat thereof. The danger of lack of faith. Lack of faith brings death. Lack of faith brings barrier. Lack of faith brings blockage. Lack of faith brings hindrance. Lack of faith brings limitations. Lack of faith brings barriers. Lack of faith brings embargoes. Samaria was delivered from financial embarrassment. He said, a bag, amen, of barley shall be sold for 1 shekel. When they were spending how much to buy even ordinary dung of doves, feces of doves. He now said, amen. He said, the measure of fine flour shall be sold for 1 shekel and 2 measures of barley for 1 shekel. The people that have been buying the dove sheet, amen, for 5 pieces of silver. They are now buying 2 bags of barley for 1 shekel. Ah, the Lord will surprise you. In the name of Jesus. You are going through famine right now. You are going through financial inflation right now, but the Lord will surprise you by his mighty power in the name of Jesus. The Lord that created the heavens and the earth will surprise you. But don't kill it with unbelief. Don't kill it with lack of faith. A lot of people are suffering today because of, you know, something like this. An officer doubted the prophecy. The Bible says, believe in the Lord your God, and thou shalt be established. Believe in his prophets, and thou shalt prosper. Believing in prophets and prophecies brings prosperity. Believing in God, the owner of the prophet and the prophecy, establishes you. The problem that most people have is the problem of this officer. We have been here now for 5 days. Deliverance from financial embarrassment. You have prayed. I even know you prayed. Some of you fasted. I know you fasted. But I beg you, heaven has released the blessing. Don't kill it with unbelief. What do I mean? After now, you go and say, oh, well, I've been praying the same prayer. What has happened? Unbelief has already killed it. You don't understand. You must believe God. Hebrews 11:6 says, without faith, it is impossible to please God. For them that will come to God must believe that he is and is a rewarder of them that diligently seek him. You have diligently sought God in these 5 days. Like I said, you have fasted, you have prayed, but we need your faith. Because without faith, nothing will happen. If you look at the story of Jesus, all the healings that Jesus did in the Bible, go and look at it very well. He will always tell those that were healed, your faith has made thee whole. Which means, without their faith, they cannot be made whole. It was even so serious. A woman got power from Jesus without speaking to Jesus. He said, if but I can touch the hem of his garment, I know I'll be made whole. And everybody was thronging around Jesus. Everybody was rushing. Everybody, the woman sneered that you need to work hard. The woman penetrated the crowd. This problem that I've spent everything, that in fact that woman was going through terrible financial embarrassment. The Bible says she spent all her earnings on physicians. Is that your story? You are here. You have spent all your earnings on physicians. But today, the God that delivered that woman with the issue of blood from financial embarrassment, from health embarrassment, that God will deliver you today. In the mighty name of Jesus. She didn't mind the crowd. He said, hey, look at the crowd. How will I get to him? I don't care. All that needs to happen is that this issue of blood, this fountain that is just flowing under me, must dry up. I must touch him. And she struggled and struggled and struggled and struggled. All she was just able, you know, she said, just the hem of his garment. She knew that it's not possible for her to go near Jesus and embrace him. It's not going to happen. There's no space. All she wanted to do was just to stretch her hand, just stretch and touch the hem of the garment. Just touch, just, you know, you say touch the hem, means just able to touch the garment. It's all that, just touch it. Look at her faith. The Bible says, instantly, the issue of blood ceased. And Jesus said, virtue has just left me now. Somebody touched me. I had the disciples say, Cosmos, come for. You are welcome in Jesus' name. The disciples say, look at the thousands that are following you. Not one touch you. So I call all of them, touch you. He said, no. There are touches and there are touches. I know everybody is touching me, but somebody touched me here. And that touch is different. You will touch God. God will touch you today. You will touch Jesus. Jesus will touch you today. In the mighty name of Jesus. The woman built her faith. She did not allow herself to be discouraged because of years of afflictions, years of embarrassment. You don't know what it means? For a woman to be leaking blood every day, not menstruation now, every day, she's blood gushing. Sometimes she'll even be smelling. That was the affliction she carried for years. The Bible says for 12 years. Yeah, I remember. Bible, for 12 years. 12 solid years. She was having the issue of blood. Every woman in this prayer meeting that is having issue of blood, I command the issue of blood to dry up now by the power in the blood of Jesus. Anything that is outside your menstruation, I command it to dry up by the power in the blood of Jesus. Every bleeding that is not natural, I command it to dry up by the power in the blood of Jesus. And any power behind unnecessary bleeding in your body, let them fall down and die. Every altar behind your unnecessary bleeding, let them catch fire and burn to ashes. In the name of Jesus. Faith is very, very important. In the past, when people come to me, I remember a particular sister that came. She said, I've done deliverance about 7 times. I've met this, I've met that. I've met this general of Asia, I've met that general of Asia. In fact, as she was talking, I even felt a bit intimidated myself. When you have met all the general of Asia, I said, why are you coming to me? So I said, Lord, what do I do? And the Holy Spirit whispered to me. He said, the lady that is sitting in front of you, she's a righteous child of God. True, true, she's not committing sin. She's not a fornicator. She's not an adulterer. She's actually living holy. And I said, Lord, so what's the problem? He said, it is doubt in her mind. It is complaint in her mind. It is murmur in her mind. It is anxiety in her mind. I said, Lord, when does all this become sin? He said, son, you don't understand. He said, I told you, in 2 Timothy chapter 1 verse 7, that God has not given you the spirit of fear. When you have fear, you will damage your testimony. He's not giving you the spirit of fear, but of power. If you don't have power, you are weak in faith. It will damage your testimony. It will damage your miracle. He said he has not given you the spirit of fear, but of power, of love. If you don't have love in your mind, you are not loving God. You are complaining, you are murmuring. It will damage your destinies. And it will damage your testimonies. He said God has not given you an unsound mind. The Lord has not given you the spirit of fear, but of power, of love, and of a sound mind. He says, son, she has fear. Son, she has an unsound mind. And she has been in this problem now for more than 25 years. If she does not correct that, she's going to die the way she is. I said, Jesus. So you don't need to conduct any deliverance. The only deliverance she needs is the deliverance of her mind. Jehovah, say yes. So I faced her. I said, this is what the Lord told me. She looked at me. Said, Pastor, that is what is going on in my life. I go for deliverance. I know that I'm delivered. After about 7 days,
my mind goes back into, you know, well, God, why is this happening to me? I was a virgin before I got married. I was this, I was that. Why did I meet the wrong man? Why did I have to divorce? Why is this going on in my life? Why am I having a spirit husband that is sleeping with me even when I'm awake? One of her problems. She'll be walking along the street and she'll be, spirit husband will be having sex with her. I've never had that before in my life. She'll be walking along the street. She'll be awake and spirit husband is sleeping with her. I'm telling you this. There are strange things in this world. He said, I don't know why this is happening to me. And the Holy Spirit said, whenever her mind goes into all those thinking, why this, why that, he said the door that was shut against the spirit husband becomes opened again. So after 7 days of a wonderful deliverance that has chased away the spirit husband comes back again and is even more ferocious now. She tells me, he said, he rapes me. He said, Pastor, you will not believe. He said, my private part, I feel pain physically. I said, ordinary dream? He said, no, it's not dream. I'm telling you this. It happened to my auntie. It was that my auntie that transferred. Because when I was having problems, when my husband left me and I was in a very bad mood, I went to stay with that auntie. And everybody knew that auntie, that she had a terrible spirit husband, that the spirit husband was sleeping with her, even when she was awake. And the things started happening to me. He said, Pastor, the day the spirit husband came into my life, I knew that day. I was sleeping in the afternoon in the house. When something just came upon me. And since that day, he never left me. Unbelief, lack of faith, can be a killer of testimonies. Hallelujah. Because this man said, can it be? So when it happened, he too was rushing to go. I mean, everybody wanted food. The Bible says he fell down and they stampeded him to death. He was stampeded to death. They marched him to death. He saw it. He saw the fine flour that was being sold for a shekel. He saw everything according to prophecy. But his lack of faith buried him before his testimony. I pray for you. You will not be buried before your testimony. In the name of Jesus. And I'm going back to that person that wants to commit suicide. You are looking at me right now. Don't try it. You will not be buried before your testimony. Every power that is pushing you to kill yourself is because you've seen that the testimony is at your door. The Lord will bury them. In the name of Jesus. Let us begin to thank God. Let us begin to bless God. Of course, you need Jesus to help you. Because without Jesus, you cannot have the kind of faith that you need. You need to surrender your life to Jesus. He's the father of faith. He's the owner of faith. He's the one that will give faith to you. Live a holy and a righteous life. Study the word of God. Look at the word of God. The way we are looking at it, line by line, precept by precept. You've seen it yourself. How the enemy lays siege on people. And poverty, financial embarrassment, financial failure, all manner of things happening to them. And just like I'm telling somebody, oh, you need to pray. Somebody is here for 7 days. Every siege of darkness on my destiny scattered by the power in the blood of Jesus. Every siege of darkness that is not allowing me access to funding, to loans, you know, scattered by the power. In the blood of Jesus. You cannot do anything without faith. You have to believe God. I know you have been in this situation for years. But you see, it's God. The same yesterday, today, and forever. He's the God of the Bible. He's still performing miracles even now. Because I can tell you so many miracles that God, raw miracles, that God has performed in my life, in my wife, in my children. No, it's real. God is real. Miracles are real. I'm telling you. As a pastor, amen, I've been in ministry now for more than 2 decades. As a pastor,
the miracles I've seen in the lives of people, I know that God is still performing miracles. Yes, I know. For some years you have been believing, but nothing is happening. Don't worry. Your time has finally come. In the name of Jesus. You will be among those that will testify to the goodness of the living God. In the mighty name of Jesus. You will dance. You will dance your dance. You will jubilate. You will celebrate by the power in the blood of Jesus. Because like I'm saying, there are people here within 3 weeks, or somebody here before the end of this year, I say you begin to plan your marriage. Not that you are meeting, you are planning the marriage. Thank you, Holy Spirit, for reminding me of that prophecy. Father, we just bless you all. And just give him all the glory. Give him all the honor. Give him all the adorations. Just bless him for all he has done for you during this 1 week of deliverance from financial embarrassment and confusion. Say, Father, Lord, I thank you because I know you have delivered me and I will never again be embarrassed. Financially, maritally, career-wise, job-wise, I will never be embarrassed again because you have taken over my life. I want you to go ahead and talk to him. Go ahead and talk to him. Just thank him. Thank him for giving you the golden opportunity to take part in this deliverance. Just give him all the glory. I know your story has already changed because he's God. He's not a man that should lie. Neither is he a son of man that should repent of his word. Has he not said it? Will he not do it? Has he not spoken it? Will he not make it good? Our God is an awesome God. Thank you, Father. Blessed be your holy name. For in Jesus' name we pray. I pray for you. You will come back with powerful testimonies in the mighty name of Jesus. The Lord will so surprise you that even you yourself, you will not believe it. That you mean this can happen in my life? After so many years, I can actually have breakthrough? Yes, that is you. That is your story in the mighty name of Jesus. Let's go ahead and thank God for Mountain of Fire Miracles Ministries, Tampa, Florida. And just bless God for all he has done, he's doing, and he will continue to do in MFM Tampa, Florida. Father, we just give you all the glory. Thank you for loving this church. Thank you for blessing this church. Thank you for the word of God that is coming out of MFM Tampa, Florida. Thank you for the revelations, for the salvation, for the deliverance, for the healing that is coming out of this church. Thank you, Lord God in heaven, for all those that you have saved, especially through this program, Hour of Deliverance Power. Father, let your name be glorified. Thank you for all those that you have delivered, you have saved, you have healed, even in this 1 week of deliverance from financial embarrassment and confusion. Father, I know you have healed a lot of credits. All the credits that have gone bad, miraculously they will go, they will become excellent again by the power in the blood of Jesus. Father, we thank you. Thank you for the pastor in Mountain of Fire Miracles Ministries, Tampa, Florida. Thank you for the ministers. Thank you for the workers. Thank you for the members. Thank you for all the online members. Thank you for all our family members. It shall be well with us all in the name of Jesus. Father, we are going into the weekend. It shall be a glorious weekend. It shall be an excellent weekend in the mighty name of Jesus. No evil shall befall us. No evil shall come near our dwelling. No evil shall befall any member of our family. It's only with our eyes that we shall see and behold the reward of the wicked in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. And every power, every kingdom that is not of God, that is attacking, harassing MFM Tampa, Florida, Father, bury them alive in the name of Jesus. Everyone that comes to MFM Tampa, Florida will prosper. Everyone that comes to MFM Tampa, Florida, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, the God of Elijah, that answered by fire, shall fight for us in the mighty name of Jesus. Let's go ahead and thank God for our Father and the Lord, Dr. Daniel Kolawole Olukoya. You are welcome in the name of Jesus. God bless you in the name of Jesus. Sarah Upai, God bless you, ma. You are welcome in the name of Jesus. Let's thank God for our Father and the Lord. We will pray for him every day we come here. Dr. Daniel Kolawole Olukoya, Mommy Shade Olukoya, their children, I soak them all in the blood of Jesus. The Lord will fight their battles. The Lord will continue to lift up their heads. The Lord will continue to give them victory round about by the power of his holy name. In the name of Jesus. Alice Godwin, God bless you in the name of Jesus. It shall continually be well with them for the rest of their lives. In the name of Jesus. The agenda of the kingdom of darkness to pull them down shall be destroyed by the power in the blood of Jesus. The Lord will continue to be a wall of fire around Dr. Daniel Kolawole Olukoya, around Mommy Shade Olukoya and their children. In the mighty name of Jesus. They will fulfill the assignment. Yes, they will fulfill the assignment. They will complete the assignment by the power and the blood of Jesus. They will make heaven. They will not miss heaven. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. And on the last day, their story will be, well done, great and faithful servant. Enter into your rest. In the mighty name of Jesus. With a crown of glory on their heads. By the power. In the blood of Jesus. I pray for you and I. We too will make heaven. In the name of Jesus. Our family members, we shall make heaven. No one will end up in hellfire. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Let's go ahead and thank God for Mountain of Fire Miracles Ministries worldwide. We soak the church in the blood of Jesus. The Lord will continue to build MFM worldwide. The gate of hell that is backing against it right now shall not prevail. In the name of Jesus, every gate of hell that is backing against MFM worldwide right now shall be broken into pieces. Every bar of iron shall be cut asunder. In the name of Jesus. The Bible says, no weapon that is formed against us shall prosper. It's every tongue that shall rise up against us in judgment, we shall condemn. Every tongue of darkness that is speaking against MFM worldwide, that is speaking against the General Overseer, Dr. Olukoya, we condemn them today. We command them to catch fire. In the name of Jesus. Every tongue speaking against the body of Christ, they will put themselves in trouble. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Oh, yes. Maraba Shakatari Baba. He said, he that leads into captivity shall be led into captivity. Every tongue that is trying to lead MFM worldwide into captivity shall go into captivity. In the name of Jesus. Every tongue that wants to lead Dr. Daniel Olukoya, his wife and children into captivity shall go into captivity. In the mighty name of Jesus. Pray for yourself too. Any tongue that wants to lead me and my family into captivity shall go into captivity by the power in the blood of Jesus. I want to once again thank you for joining me to pray for President Trump of America. We pray for him once again that it shall be well with him in Jesus' name, that this COVID will not bury him. He will get out of it. He will be delivered. The hand of Jesus will touch him. He will see Jesus during this period. He and Jesus will talk face to face. In the mighty name of Jesus. He will completely give his life to Christ and he will be an excellent leader in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. We pray for his wife too. The power of God will heal them and no one will be infected anymore in their family. And if there's any more persons that are infected, the blood of Jesus will heal them all in the name of. They are our leader. They are the first family. The hand of God will be upon them. We rescue them and we deliver and heal them. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. We pray also for Vice President Biden too, and his wife and children. The hand of God shall be upon them. The wall of fire of the living God shall continue to protect them in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. The Lord will continue to help that family too. Even their running mate Pence and his family, Kamala Harris and her family, the hand of God, the wall of fire shall continually be upon them in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. We pray for the land. It shall be well with this land. In the name of any land where you are, because I know people are praying from different parts of the world. Wherever you are, it shall be well with your land by the power in the blood of Jesus. It shall be well with your land in the name of Jesus. Even if there's war in your land, the peace of God will swallow it in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Well, I pray especially for the November 3rd election in America. I pray once again, I soak that day in the blood of Jesus. It shall be a day of peace. It shall be a day of progress. It shall be a day when the will of God will be done in America. In the mighty name of Jesus. I pray especially for the will of God. Father, we don't care who the will of God is, as long as it's the will of God. It is your will that will be enthroned in America as the next president. In the mighty name of Jesus. Be it Biden, be it Trump, let your will be done. We want your will. We don't want anything. We just want your will. And let your will be done, Lord.
in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. There shall be no war, there shall be no trouble in the mighty name of God. And I pray once again, all those that are planning war, Father, let them sleep now and wake up after the president must have been elected and announced. In the mighty, they will not die, but they will sleep for this period by the power and the blood of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you for everything. To you we give all the glory. Father, let the blood of Jesus flush out coronavirus from our land. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father, because you have answered all our prayers. Let your name be glorified. For in Jesus' name we have prayed. Amen. 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 In Jesus' name. Let us share the grace now. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. For some of us that are doing dry fast, if you have been doing dry fast for the past 3 days, you can break it now. That we have finished the program. We are doing actually 1 day of dry fast today, again into tomorrow, Power Must Change Hands program, which is a worldwide program in Mountain of Fire Miracles Ministries. If you feel led, I want you to also continue to fast, do a dry fast, especially those that have not fasted. You can seize this opportunity to do a dry fast until tomorrow when the program finishes. Hallelujah. The Lord will help us in Jesus' name. Keep on liking our page. For all those that are liking, I see you liking the page. God bless you in the name of Jesus. Please keep on liking the page. Keep on loving the page. Keep on sharing the video. And do a watch party with the video. Remember, you are an evangelist to the world. Even if you cannot physically go to people, you can use your platform to touch a lot of lives. Because there are a lot of people that will be connected to your platform that are going to see this video and are going through what we have prayed about in the past 1 week. And I know that God will use you to bless them. So please keep on sharing until the unreached is reached. God bless you in the mighty name of Jesus. Remember to also visit our YouTube channel. Subscribe to it, MFM Tampa, Florida. MFM Tampa, Florida. God bless you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Please continue to observe the social distancing rules. Please keep 6 feet from anyone that is not an immediate family member. Please wash your hands, sanitize yourself, wear a face mask if you have to go out and be in a public place. God bless you in the mighty name of Jesus. Have a beautiful, beautiful, beautiful weekend in the mighty name of Jesus. And pray that there shall be a rain of testimonies for you. Yes, during this weekend, in the mighty name of Jesus, there shall be a rain of testimonies for me and my family too, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. And between now and on Monday again, when we shall see again by the special grace of God, let us shout 7 powerful hallelujah. Let's go. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. God bless you mightily. See you on Monday with powerful testimonies. In the mighty name.